Morning, we are kicking off Memorial Day with a backyard barbecue, and not just any backyard barbecue, but we're going to show you how to turn your grill into a Hawaiian feast. Joining us this morning from King's Hawaiian is Courtney Tyler. Thanks for being here.
Thanks so much for having me here.
You have no idea how many people you have made happy just by being here today. Everybody is so happy we're going to have a luau.
I'm glad to be here then.
All right, let's tell everybody what we're going to make.
What we're going to make is we're going to first start with spinach and artichoke dip.
Right.
And so that's what we call the Islander artichoke and spinach dip. And then we'll do a little bit of little kahuna sliders, which is chicken and vegetables. And then we have regular sliders, you know, hamburger patty,
sure,
whatever else you want.
Right.
And then we just have our bread pudding there so you can take a look at it.
And that looks, you're teasing us with that. That looks awesome. What are some of the ingredients that we have that we need to get together so that we can make these?
For the little kahuna sliders, all you need is Italian dressing, some oregano and basil, and then grilled vegetables, really whatever you want. So bell peppers and onions, and then of course pineapple.
Well, it wouldn't be Hawaiian without pineapple.
Not
right?
Really.
Right, and then we have our King's Hawaiian bread, right?
King's Hawaiian rolls.
And we can get these anyplace.
And you can get these any of your local grocery stores or food retailer stores in the bakery and deli.
Okay, perfect. So it's not official unless we have the King's Hawaiian.
It's definitely not official, and it's definitely not Hawaiian unless
right.
You have King's Hawaiian.
All right, perfect. Okay, thank you so much. We have our ingredients ready to go. In the meantime, let's take a look back at some of our favorite moments from the show.
We are kicking off Memorial Day with a backyard barbecue, but we're putting a twist on your, you know, typical grill menu, and we're turning it into a Hawaiian feast. So Courtney Tyra from King's Hawaiian, you are here to show us how to make a good snack, a good starter, mm-hmm, really an anytime treat.
So we're going to be doing the Islander artichoke and spinach dip, and in our round bread, which is right here,
mm-hmm,
and really a lot of people want to know like how to make that round cut and how
yes
to do this, and so
without cutting it all the way through
or without making it look funny. But this is a trick that my dad actually taught me a couple years ago, and all you do is put a bowl or anything a little bit smaller than the round bread on top. And then you're just going to cut...
Right around.
And it just helps, you know, the appearance come out very clear and
mm-hmm
clean. And, you know, I actually cut mine all the way through and then just cut a little portion of the bottom out.
Okay.
And then I just put it back in. But, you know, some people will just dig it out.
Excellent.
And all you do is just go all the way around.
I'll just pop right out. Excellent. And remind everyone, too, what went into your spinach dip?
In the spinach dip is a spinach, an artichoke, sour cream
yum
cheese. It has some water chestnuts, but everything is on kingswine.com.
Okay, great. So you're going to pop that out. We're going to scoop the dip into the bowl. I'll, of course, give it a try. But for now, back to you.
Back outside for a Memorial Day barbecue turned Hawaiian
yes
style.
Yes, absolutely.
With Courtney Tyra from King's Hawaiian, and we're making up these sliders, so let's make them.
So
I'm hungry.
The first one we're going to make is the little kahuna sliders, which is right here, and it's just chicken.
Mm-hmm.
So we have the chicken right here, and we're going to marinate it in some Italian dressing.
Okay.
Yum.
And oregano and basil, and you just sort of mix all of it in there together.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, you know, the longer you can marinate it, the better.
The better,
but
the flavor's,
you know,
going to be throughout.
Yeah, definitely. Just throw it in early in the morning if you have time.
Okay.
And then, let's see, what do we have here? And then you can grill vegetables. So
mm-hmm
I like bell peppers. So we have red bell peppers, green bell peppers, which I'm going to throw on the grill right now.
Yep.
And then onions if you like, you know, regular
sure
or...
The red onions.
The red onions.
Red onions.
Yep. So I'm going to throw these on the
okay
grill.
Okay, and we already have some chicken and...
Cooking away.
Little burger on there, too.
So place those on.
That has been cooking.
It smells
that's
good.
That's what I love about the summertime. I mean, to having all of those grilled items, whether they're chicken, vegetables, a whole lot of options.
And everything tastes better when it's on the grill.
Yes, it does.
It really does. It does.
It does.
It tastes so good.
You nailed it.
All right, so Courtney,
right,
we've got,
so those
we've
are
got that
cook
going
up.
So we got that going, and I guess since we already have, well, we could throw this piece of chicken
okay
in.
Yeah.
Since
oh,
it's been
yeah,
marinating for a whole minute.
And let's go over the assembly now of one of those that's maybe been cooking for a little while, either the burger
sure
or the chicken.
So we're just going to put the bottom of the roll. So this is our original Hawaiian sweet, but
mm-hmm
you can do savory butter or honey wheat, you know, whichever flavor you really want.
Ooh, sure.
All sound good.
Now tell everybody, I mean, for everybody who's, you know, may not be familiar, does it almost taste like a Portuguese sweetbread or how, what's
it
taste
definitely
like?
It's inspired by the Portuguese sweetbread, so it has that sweet flavor,
right,
except
mm-hmm
it's soft and fluffier.
Okay.
And so it also will last longer than the Portuguese sweetbread, which is known for getting a little hard after, you know, one day.
Oh, yeah. Right. Yep. You got to eat it fast.
You got to eat it really fast.
All right, so we have our chicken on there, and while those vegetables are just finishing up, talk about, too, the variety. You also have, I think, like a pork option here.
So right here we have a pulled pork sandwich, so perfect for barbecue and whatever, you know, whatever you want to throw on there, really, with the coleslaw or anything.
Yum.
And then we have a hamburger patty right there, which I can actually throw this one on the grill right now, too.
Great.
With the other one we have going. And you can throw anything you want on it, you know, onions or grilled pineapple if you want to do that, which I'll throw these on right now, too.
Perfect.
Okay.
That makes it classic.
That does, absolutely. You're going to have a luau, you need pineapples.
And when you grill it, the flavor really comes out in pineapple, so it's really a nice touch.
Yeah. I think people sometimes get skeptical when they're grilling fruit.
Right, about what they can put on the grill.
Definitely. So let me finish assembling these.
Okay. Yum. Oh, they look so good. Nice and fresh, too. That's what I love.
So my onions are slightly... depends on how much you want to cook them, really.
Sometimes you like that bite, though. I mean, I know people that just...
definitely. And then you can put on some peppers.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Maybe if you want another green pepper for extra...
Oh, we're stacking it.
Extra color.
This is a big bite. And then, of course, you have to top it with that pineapple like you did that other one, huh?
That makes it official with the pineapple on top.
Oh, yum.
And then you can just throw this on top.
Okay.
And then if you want, you can throw the pineapple there.
And then we need the cool toothpick.
Skewer it all the way through.
And you skewer it all the way through, and you're ready for your memorial party.
That looks fantastic.
Yum. And something else that's on the table that has been making our mouths water all morning long. Please tell us about this bread pudding.
That is the white chocolate chip bread pudding. So it's actually my personal favorite, and it's just the bread.
Oh,
any of our bread, really, you just cube it up, and it has white chocolate chips, and it has some cream and butter and sugar and vanilla. And again, you know, you can go to kingshawaiian.com and find that recipe.
I don't know what to go for first.
I'm going to have one of these. And you know, another thing, I don't know if we've mentioned, but you're the granddaughter of the founder of Kingshawaiian, right?
Yes, I am the granddaughter. So the company was started about 6 years ago, all the way in Hilo, by my grandfather, and then my father runs the company today, and then there are probably about maybe 20, 25 of us working, so it's a huge family
business.
Business affair. We all work together, and it's
excellent.
Fun.
And remind everyone, too, what section of the grocery store or the market?
The deli and the bakery, so not in your bread aisle, but in the specialty section in the deli.
And a lot of the local markets around here will have this.
Yes, and if not, you can go to kingshawaiian.com and put in your zip code and find a store.
Very good.
And really quickly, you're also making a donation to the food bank.
Yes, so we are donating to the local Providence Food Bank, just because obviously food is super important for Kingshawaiian, and so what better way than to share with food.
Oh, great. Well, we can't wait to dig in and enjoy our Memorial Day.
Absolutely.
Enjoy your Memorial Day, too, if you're grilling out there. Courtney, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. You can find all these recipes online now at WPRI.com.